Hello future engineers, today we are looking at the fantastic world of steam power and running through the setup for the thermal power plant with steam turbine, the TD1060V. To set up the 1060V, firstly turn on the power supply. When this happens, the fans automatically engage. Then turn on the electric heater and set your target temperature via the PID controller. Next, turn on the pump and set the desired speed for the test. Ensure the bypass valve is open. Now wait for the machine to reach the desired temperature, and once it has, ensure you zero the load cell, then prepare the load cell which is visible on the display. Connect VDAS to the apparatus to automatically capture the experiment results. Close the bypass valve and wait for the pressure to build up. As the turbine is getting started, you'll notice the pressure slowly build up and the turbine speed increase. You can control the load the generator applies to the turbine by turning the knob. By varying the load, you can change the speed of the turbine. When the turbine is at the desired speed to take your first result, engage VDAS to capture the next data. Next, change the load to the second desired speed and take results. You can keep repeating this step for results of varying turbine speed. Once you've captured all your results on VDAS and have finished the experiment, you can move on to a new experiment or shut down the system. If you're not going to use the apparatus within the next hour or so, you can cool it down more rapidly by leaving the fans going. If you're going to reuse the machine within the next 10 minutes, you can turn the fans off but keep the machine on and ready. You can reuse the machine to perform further experiments, such as investigating steam flow rate, that could involve changing the amount of steam nozzles in use. The 4 steam nozzles and 4 taps should only be adjusted by a competent person or lab technician. To shut down the system, turn off the apparatus, the heaters, and open the bypass valve. Turn off the water pump and either leave the fans on or turn them off depending on your desired outcome. Now we have successfully set up the apparatus, run an experiment and shut down the system. Let's understand the engineering principles behind it. This steam turbine operates on the principles of the Rankine cycle, a fundamental concept in thermodynamics. It's all about converting thermal energy into mechanical power efficiently. The TD1060V is more than just a machine, it's a powerful teaching tool. It's the only electrically powered equipment that shows how steam can generate electricity in a closed-loop Rankine cycle. This is cutting edge for engineering students and was designed with sustainability in mind, reducing water consumption and wastage. This makes it ideal for institutions worldwide, especially in regions where water is a precious resource. By understanding how steam turbines generate electricity, engineers can become highly sought after given the greener and more sustainable energy trends worldwide. Looking closer at the features of the thermal power plant with steam turbine, TD1060V. It's self-contained, electric powered and equipped with a flash boiler. You can control the power output with a variable resistive load, and it even allows you to vary steam flow rate for experimentation. With integrated VDAS, you get real-time data for an energy audit, and there's a comprehensive user guide to help you along the way. The benefits of the TD1060V are many. Whether you're an educator or a student, it's perfect for closed environments like labs, ensuring safety with its flash boiler and electric power operation. Quick setup, increased repeatability, low ongoing costs, and real-time data capture make it a winner. Using the TD1060V, you'll determine, investigate, and gain valuable insights into the Rankine cycle, turbine steam consumption, energy conversion, energy system losses, thermal efficiency and mechanical efficiency, electrical power generation. The thermal power plant with steam turbine, TD1060V, isn't just a machine. It's a bridge to a greener, more sustainable future. Click the link in the description to learn more and take your first step towards becoming a greener engineer. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more engineering education videos from TecQuipment.